There's magic to Detroit. You gotta find it though, because it's hidden in the back alleys and the speakeasies and the beautiful theaters that comprise this magical city. From the back alleys and streets of Detroit comes a brand new show about music, comedy, art, and rebirth. This is The Box. To find some way as a storyteller in a world where we don't listen to each other anymore, that we could start seeing each other through one another's eyes. Mm-hmm. And thus the box was born.
Getting myself ready for a ride. So I'm gonna head down, do some people watching, some thinking, and some ranting on camera. So talk about some of the things going on in the world today. So I'll see you on the flip side.
Taking you through a little tour of Detroit, my city, the city that Trump calls hell on earth. This is it. This is Detroit, dystopian Detroit. And you can see the streets are clear. I mean, there's not a lot of people out on the streets. It feels very ghoulish sometimes, but it's a beautiful day. I love Detroit. It's a great city. It's a city where I came back to rebuild, and it has helped me to become stronger because the people here never give up. People in this town are warriors, they're lions, they're not sheep, I can tell you that right now, and they fight for everything. When I was a kid, I couldn't wait to leave this town. I wanted to, you know, I think that's what everybody does. Everybody wants to leave where they grew up in and go make their bones and go be somebody. And so I couldn't wait to get out of this town. I wanted to leave so badly. And now that I'm back, I'm happy that I'm back because this town has helped me. It's the city of my birth, and it's the city of my rebirth now. It has helped me to grow and become the person that I am again today. And I just love it. I love riding around and looking at all the great artwork in this city. It's so full of great artwork. And here's a new piece that I'm about to show you that's going up in downtown Detroit, and I love it. It's a great piece, and there it is. Experts have always said that the day Detroit falls, the rest of the country will fall, and you're beginning to see that now. Because Detroit was the generator of the middle class. We created these, I like to call them steel time machines. These beautiful cars that took us from one part of the country to another, that gave us the ability to travel freely and just move throughout the country and be able to explore and have adventures in our very own time machines. And now that Detroit has been destroyed, you're seeing the rest of the country being destroyed with it. You know, a lot of things have changed over the years about Detroit, but the one thing that remains the same is this memorial to heavyweight champion of the world and Detroit hero, Joe Louis. This iconic structure was commissioned in 1986 by Sports Illustrated at a cost of $350,000 and was donated to the city and was created by artist Robert Graham. It faces Canada for a reason, and that is to show the world that we were willing to fight the Nazi scourge across our borders. Now we're gonna head to the last mural that I'm gonna show you on this little trip around dystopian Detroit, the place that Trump calls hell on earth. And we're coming up on it in just a minute. And you can see it in the distance. It is my man, Stevie Wonder. Oh, I love Stevie Wonder. I met Stevie Wonder at the House of Blues when I was working on the Sunset Strip. And he came in to perform. And I have never met a nicer, more gracious, more wonderful star and human being in my whole life. He came out to rehearse on the stage, and as he began to rehearse, all the people in the upper balconies that were eating and stuff, everybody just came to watch him rehearse. And he played for over 2 hours for all the employees, for all of us. He just sat there on his piano. He took requests from us. He told us stories. I mean, who does that? Only Stevie Wonder does that. And that's why he's the legend that he is today. I think the disappointing part about this mural is painted by London-based artist Richard Wilson, and it was created off the iconic image that was shot by photographer Gliss Kirkland. It's a shame that they didn't commission a Detroit artist to create this iconic mural of a Detroit legend, the best there ever is and ever was and ever will be, the great Stevie Wonder. That ends my little trip around Detroit for you all. I'll be back with more videos showing you more of my city, the Motor City, the best city on the face of the planet, D-Town in the house. It is Detroit, the home of my birth, and it will be the home of my death. I love this city. It's Detroit, people. Never forget the greatest city on earth.